As a last example, let's have a look at material innovations on the power roadmap. Due to the increased power constraints, more performing batteries are needed for smart applications. A battery typically contains three major elements, a positive and a negative electrode, separated by an electrolyte. The difference in electrochemical potential between the positive cathode and the negative anode is the key driver for battery operation. During charging, electrons will flow from the cathode to the anode. This will attract positive charged lithium ions who will channel through the electrolyte separator towards the anode. During discharging, the opposite will occur. Electrons will flow from the anode, inducing the flowback of the lithium ions towards the cathode. Today's portable lithium-ion batteries use lithium cobalt oxide as cathode material, reaching 750 watt-hour per liter. In the future, energy densities will be further improved and are expected to reach 1000 watt-hour per liter in 10 years from now. State-of-the-art electric vehicle battery technology is based on nickel manganese cobalt cathode designs, moving to ever higher nickel content to increase the energy density. To enable fast charging, the graphite anode will be replaced by a silicon-containing anode. To further increase the energy density beyond 1000 watt-hour per liter, a transition from liquid lithium-ion batteries to solid-state batteries is expected. Material innovation plays an important role in the battery technology roadmap. Let's focus on the electric vehicle battery. Switching from standard polycrystalline type NMC towards an advanced higher nickel grade NMC allows to increase energy density at cell level towards 280 watt-hour per kilogram. For solid state, we observe that the coating of the material impacts significantly the stability of the material. Therefore, we are defining the right coating materials and right processes to bring us to the required 1000 watt-hour per liter energy density level. To close the circle, we need to ensure that the production waste and the end-of-life products are properly collected.